Hey, welcome to Kraaft It Live, everybody. I'm your host, Heather, and I've got with me Mr. Crafter and T-Dog holding down the fort. We are going to get right into it because we have got a lot of tree frog to glue together today. So, in keeping with this month, if you're new here, this is what we're doing. All month long, we are doing the same exact image, which is a drawing that I did a couple years ago, this tree frog, and we're going to turn him into four totally different art pieces. That's
Last
the
week's,
idea.
was it?
This is last week's, yeah. And then this week we're going to be working on this one. And last week we just did like mixed media, and then I sort of glazed over all of the glued pieces with like transparent paint. And so you can see the paper in the background and stuff, and it's really cool. And then this week we are going to take this, I already did this part. So I have like this line drawing, and I transferred the lines of the frog and the edge of the leaf onto a gessoed canvas. And I see that texture coming through that gessoed canvas. That's kind of cool. And I only did that because I wanted to have it more of a black or a white base instead of a black base, which it was a black canvas because that's all I have right now. And then earlier I did some jelly plating, and I've got the video for that. I'm going to be posting that this week. I sort of messed up on not getting that posted. But anyway, we'll go through these. And now I'm just looking for a brush so I can get started with ripping things apart and putting things together.
So we have quite a few people here.
Awesome. Let's say hi. Hi, everyone. We're kind of tired tonight, I think. Uh-oh, Mr. Crafter isn't working.
No.
Is it still on? Because
Something
it's
happened.
doing bloop bloop. Mr. Crafter, noisemaker isn't working. What is that thing even called? Microphone, that's what it's called. That's all right. We'll wait for you to get there. All right, I'm going to go ahead and get started. I got the matte medium ready to go. This is the glue I like to use. And then you can see my line drawing, hopefully, throughout this whole thing here. And then we're going to start with the background. So I have some turquoise blue. Oh, you know what? Before I get started with that, I had one thing that I wanted to share. Is that okay? Can I do
Yeah,
that
no,
one
there
thing?
we go. All right.
All right, one thing I wanted to share. Hold on. This is in my art journal. I had done a video for a blog hop that is still going on. I want to make sure that everybody knew about it. Please, after the show, of course, not right now, but there is a bunch of artists who have put together an incredible hop of videos that you'll want to check out. And this is the one that I did. And there's a giveaway and fun stuff going on. So you leave a comment and you subscribe to each of them, and you get an opportunity to win prizes from the sponsors. It was tons of fun. I just want to make sure you guys knew all about that. So back
Okay,
to this.
you did a hop and then you're making a frog today.
Sure, T, sure. All right, so
That's all that matters.
I'm gonna separate these. So I did these what are these called? Jelly print poles. And I've got two different colors of green because I wanted this one for the leaf, this darker green for the leaf, and then this for the frog's body. We don't really need as much as I've got, but there will be lots of froggies being made, I think.
So we have a whole slew of people here.
All right. A slew.
Jules and
Now they're a
Andrew.
slew.
Yeah, Jules and Andrew. Maria. Myself.
Oh, you're here too. That's
Yeah.
excellent.
Enclave. Susan. Danny. Michael Daniels. There we go. There's
All
this,
right, glad you guys are here.
that's the slew as we speak of it.
That's the slew. Awesome. Well, I'm glad you guys are here. If this is your first time here, please let us know in the comments. We do this every week. We craft live together. It's usually a lot of fun for the most part.
Kathy just showed up.
Hi, Kathy. Glad you're here.
Barb.
All right, so here's
Why?
the way we're going to do this. This one I think is going to be... This one looks a little bit more sky-ish to me. Sky-ish, sky-ish. So I'm just separating the papers now. These were all pulls that I put together earlier. Separating them by color. This is sky, sky. This one, we're going to call this one leaf. So one of the tricks to this, I like to call this collage painting, collage art, paper piecing. Paper piecing is a little bit different. If you remember the dragonfly, that's much more paper piecing, where I actually cut out pieces of paper in certain shapes. We're not going to do that today. Today we are going to rip apart paper and glue it down.
Oh, Michael Daniels, he just did it again. Thank you, Michael, for that.
Very awesome. Nice of you to do that. Great donation there. That gets us one step closer to getting on the road where we can do these live and in person in a city near you. We got a few people who are interested in seeing that come to fruition, huh?
Yeah.
All right, T-Dog has a question, everybody. Oh, yeah, it's always mixed media that we're doing here. How few times do we do something that isn't mixed media? So, this is what I'm going to be doing. I'm going to be ripping it up into smallish pieces. Sort of mosaic-like. Just trying to make sure I'm still on camera. Okay, so the goal here is to just put it into these spaces and hopefully not cover up too much of the line, because that line is what's going to keep me on track, I think, is what I'm trying to say. So just put down a layer of the matte medium and then a layer of the papers. Like I said, sort of smallish. I don't know what that is. One-inch cubes, maybe-ish? Like-ish. This is all-ish sizes. Very technical measurement.
Michael said if we come his way, he's going to be on vacation.
Yes, I know. That's his thing. Do you know that he did the same thing this morning in the daily hangout?
And you know what? That'll be perfect, because then we can use his house for the show.
Oh, I like this.
And
plan.
He won't be around. We won't interrupt him or his wife, and all is well. See how that works?
Don't worry about the dogs. We'll feed them. We'll walk them. Everything will be fine, Michael. No worries. I like that plan, Mr. Crafter. Smart. Always thinking.
Or we just do it in the motorhome out in front of his house and steal his...
Do the show outside, not tell him that we're there. That would be actually quite hilarious, I think. We're coming to you from the lawn of Michael Daniels. Yeah, we're hoping it's Michael Daniels.
Nikki just showed up, and Sandra.
Hey, Nikki, glad you're here.
Well.
Oh, Sandra. Sandra's not feeling well, everybody. So big hugs to Miss Sandra. Hoping that watching some art will make you feel better.
Sandra's also watching on her TV.
Oh, now that's so cool when she does that. I bet she posted a picture of it on Instagram. Maybe. Maybe not. All right, so far this is like looking... Well, pretty much like a mosaic mess. We'll get there. So I'm just putting down like a base layer. Some of these may get covered up, and that's totally fine too. The goal here is to just have the entire canvas covered in these little bits of paper, and they'll overlap. That's why I'm spreading them out like this. All right. See if I can just wait on that one. I really like this paper with these kind of purpley bits. We're going to add that to it too.
Kathy wants to know, what medium are you using to glue down Your bits of paper.
It's Deco Art Media, Matte Medium. Matte Medium.
So do we still have that Amazon affiliate link?
Yes, dear.
They do it through the website. Go through the website and click on the link and order away.
Yeah, there's a link down in the description of this video that'll take you to all of our support options. One of those support options is when you order through Amazon. If you click on our link first, all your orders, all of the orders that you make on Amazon will be affiliated with the Kraaft Shaak. It's just another way to support, and it doesn't cost you anything extra.
Laura just showed up.
Problem with doing these little bits of pieces and stuff is that when you put the paper down or the canvas down, then little bits and pieces fly everywhere, which is what we just experienced, isn't it? All right, so far so good. What do we think?
Looking cool so far.
All right.
Let me move it up a smidgen. There you go.
I just ruined my shot.
I didn't mean to ruin your shot. Sorry. Miscommunication from the director. All right, so I've got this. It's like tissue paper.
Bless you.
Bless you. That's funny. I was hoping not to do the same color scheme every time, but we'll see what happens, I guess.
We may end up running out of colors.
I don't think she'll ever run out of colors.
Yeah, there's no such thing as running out of colors.
Boxes and boxes of it.
All right, so now I'm just going to focus on gluing all the way around. Yeah. Well, that's kind of cool. I'm going to turn this one over, and it's the other side, and you get to see those scissors. Isn't that neat? Can you guys see that?
Yeah,
it's a little pair of scissors right there. So this deli paper, or no, tissue paper, it's like printed. That's how come I didn't finish the statement before, because you interrupted. Okay, so the tissue paper, don't say it, has little Kraaft images all over it. Can you guys see that? Little Kraaft images. And this was a gift, I believe, from either Lynn's or Jules. It's hard to tell when I get gifts from those guys as to which one gave it. Oh, the fun. Okay, so this is really cool. Just putting down in the back area here. Put a little bit of this paper back here too. All right, and you'll notice too that it's kind of getting milky. The more of the matte medium that we use, the more milky it appears to be, and that's because it needs to dry. It'll dry totally clear and completely see through. It'll be very nice. Very, very nice.
Jules says, I love watching paper piecing. Looks amazing when finished.
It's a fun process because, it's just little bits and pieces, and then they just sort of come together this way. So it's kind of a cool thing to watch while you're chatting along with friends in the live chat over there. If you're watching the replay and you don't get to show up for these live events, we want you to know that we still think of you even while we're live here and you're not able to be here. We know you could if you would if you could, right? Isn't that what they say?
Kathy says it looks very therapeutic as well.
It is very therapeutic to actually glue the bits down, for sure.
A couple of the people mentioned your buffalo and one of the other thing, dragonfly.
Yep, the butterfly, or sorry, the dragonfly and the buffalo, that was me putting buffalo and dragonfly together, were a little bit different because they weren't done in this torn paper piece process. They weren't done this way. They were actually, the pieces were cut from in the shape of the drawing. So like cutting out his head and gluing that down and then cutting out each eye and gluing that down. But today we're doing it differently. And today we're really hoping that we get finished with this one. Next week we have an idea that was given to us by Sandra. I actually ordered some paints so that we could do a really cool process. I'm really excited about it. I'm nervous as heck, but I'm excited about it. And I'm looking forward to being able to do that. So you'll want to tune in next week for sure to see.
Sunny Laureed said, I wish I could do what you guys do. She means filming and YouTube and doing my artwork.
Yeah, it's not easy. You got to have a team. I would not be able to do this without the guys, that's for sure. And before that, it was Sandra and Sylvia in the audience. They would help me with the comments and stuff. And this allows me to focus on just doing the artwork and not have to worry about remembering what to say or when to say it or push buttons, because pushing buttons is kind of hard too. So when you got glue everywhere. I think it's a little bit more fun for the audience, too, because you're not listening to me go, all right, now what was that you said? I can't see the comments at the same time, and then I stop. And I think it works out best for everybody having the guys here, don't you think? Round of applause for the guys.
Yeah, round of applause.
That was pathetic, just so you know. That was truly pathetic.
Mr. Crafter says, sounds like you need a cameraman.
That's what Mr. Crafter said? You're Mr. Crafter.
That was T-Dog. Kathy said, I just found you and really loved your piece using the pears in your art journal.
Oh, Kathy, thank you so much. We had so many wonderful people make such great comments on that piece. And I am very grateful to each and every one of them. I'm trying to get through answering all those. That's a job and a half. But yeah. We're glad you're here. We hope you enjoy. This is what we do every week, is this live feed where we do something, some sort of art adventure together. And we like to, we can't wait, really, to be able to do this on the road with folks and have a live adventure in person with people watching in the audience. Not Michael Daniels, but other people, right?
Yep.
Anybody but Michael.
Nikki says, love the prickly pear. Won a while back. This is going to be so cute.
Oh, the prickly pear was a little bit more like this, because what we did with that one, oh, that was so much fun. We punched out, we like used shaped punches. You know what I'm talking about? Like you take the paper and you put it in a punch and you go kabunk, kabunk, and you get a shape out of that. That's what I'm talking about. No, good. I knew you were going to say that.
Sorry,
kapunk, kapunk.
Oh my gosh, you guys are no fun. Anyway, it was like butterflies and hearts. It's tons of fun. Yep. And it now proudly hangs in the new owner's house, which happens to be my cousin's house, and her daughter bought it. So that makes me very happy. All right, I love this. Look at that. Stinking cute. All right, the sky is almost finished.
Stinking cute.
Stinking cute. The sky is almost finished, and what do we have left? 10 minutes. All right, awesome. Just kidding. All right, so there's the sky.
It's really 11.
There's the sky. That's pretty cool, don't you think, guys?
Yeah, it looks great.
Yeah. All right, so whew, the next thing. It is definitely time consuming, and I am kind of rushing through some things here. I want to show you how I would take care of like this little space.
You're like it is definitely time consuming. That's why I forgot to tell you. Today's show is going to be 7 years long.
Yes, today's show is going to be a long one, but that's not true. We usually try to do this in about an hour. If I can't get it finished, it'll probably be a little bit more than an hour, but of course, you don't have to stick around. You can watch the replay, catch the rest of it. All right, let's move this color off to the side a little bit, and we're going to grab this pile of papers that I've put aside over here. And this is for the leaf.
Kathy Judd said, "Glad I found you. Can't wait to see more." And she should probably go to the website and link to the YouTube from there.
Yeah, we
see
have
more videos.
Yeah, but she's here on YouTube, so YouTube is where you want to see all the go. All of our past episodes are listed there in we have them listed by season, we have them listed by topics. Yeah, if you're just into mixed media, you can check things out in the mixed media playlist. If you like watercolors, we have couple of watercolor playlists, you can check those out. We did a watercolor Wednesdays for a little bit of time last year. Things were different last year. You know, one of the things that your support does do for the Craft Shack, if you are so inclined to help us out with Super Chat or becoming a traveler, that's really our favorite way for you to support the Craft Shack is becoming a traveler. We give you freebies like the tree frog printout is available over there now for travelers only, among other things. But when you help us out as a traveler or using our Amazon affiliate link or even doing the Super Chat like Michael did tonight, no matter what, that goes to us getting on the road and being able to come and do this live art near you. And this weekend is Saturday, right?
Yes.
Saturday, we are going to be doing a live and location. We won't be doing it live on YouTube. We will be doing it in person here in Mesa, Arizona. So if you happen to be anywhere near Mesa, Arizona, you might want to check out a free event where we will be hanging out. And I did put a link on Facebook about that. It's Made in Mesa. Made on Main. Yeah, Made on Main.
I think.
I'm pretty sure that's what it's called. Made on Main. Here in Mesa, Arizona. It's a free event. You can come check it out. We'll have some artwork on display. I'll be painting live. Should be a good time. But yeah, those are just some of the many things we're going to do. So I'm using bigger pieces this time for this portion of it because, well, I want to get done faster for one thing. I'm just going to tell the truth. But also because this is a different object, so I really want it to have a different look and feel. So there's different ways to do this. When you are piecing your image together, you can obviously just cut out a big old leaf and paste it down. You can do like we're doing now and sort of mosaic it on there.
Jules wants to know about this Saturday, if we will be recording and putting on here.
No, I don't think that we'll be able to do that because, first of all, it's not a Craft Shack event. It's an event that we were invited to be a part of, so I don't want to step on anyone's toes, but also because we never know what the internet is going to be like, and we really don't know what the heck the event itself is going to be like. Will we even have the time or ability to do any of that stuff? I don't know. So it's probably just easiest if I just say, probably not. Don't you think?
Yeah.
Probably the best answer.
If we do, it'll be spur of the moment. Like Instagram or something would be the only thing I would think of.
Well, I'm definitely going to post some pictures and stuff. So you'll be able to see that on Instagram. If you're not already following us on Instagram, this is what you're missing out. Behind the scenes stuff, like getting ready for events and stuff like that, as well as live while we are doing these shows, like right now, T-Dog is over there posting close-up shots and things that you don't really get to see while you're watching live here on YouTube. So you'll want to check that out. And if you are unfamiliar with Instagram, even if you don't have an Instagram account, you can still watch by going to the link in our description, and it's right there on the page. We have it right there for you. You don't even have to go anywhere. You can just watch it right there on the page, and then if you do click it, it'll take you straight to our Instagram. So we're kind of cool the way we've got some of this stuff, don't you think, honey?
Trying to be dare.
Yep. All right, almost done with this leaf. Not too bad, huh?
She stepped that speed up, didn't she?
Well, using larger pieces, I think, helped. But also, I'm in the groove. This truly is a therapeutic thing for me. It's not for everybody. I know some people, this would really be irritating to have to do all this gluing and stuff. But I like it. It's kind of like fussy cutting shapes. Some people really dislike that. And some people really love it. Oh, just adorable. Let's get this piece here torn apart.
No tissue on that section?
Sorry, not yet. There will be. Just not yet. I like going in all the different directions because it's adding to the whole feel of it. But see, I don't want to put too much in one area like I did just there. That's too much dark green in one area, but we'll fix it. All right. This, so I think, is part of the frog.
Maybe real soon we'll be able to announce that whole 100-day deal.
Oh, you just had to say that, didn't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, I hope to...
We've just been slammed with so many other things.
Way too many other things have been going on. No, that's too big. I don't want that on there. Tore it off.
Make it smaller.
All right. There, I like that. That's better. This one's going to go down here. Mr. Photographer over here. Am I in your way, sir? He says, yes, you are, but I'm working around you, of course. All right. 100 paintings in 100 days. There's going to be an announcement. Honest, I promise. I've just got to get a few things worked out before I can officially say it has begun. It's not been super easy. I love these little scissors on this. This is cool. See how that tissue just disappears into there? That's so cool.
Bless you. Andrew says, I think I'm really going to like this frog. I hope he likes it enough to add to the other one.
To his collection?
Yeah.
His dragonfly?
Yeah, the dragonfly. Wow, I can't even...
Well, I will tell you, this is one of the ones that will be available to travelers to choose as a part of the 100 paintings in 100 days thing when I do actually announce it. This will be one of them, I promise. So if there is...
Four of the frogs?
Probably.
Four frogs.
Four frogs. All right. It
Two
looks like
doves.
No turtle doves. No. There are no turtle doves involved. Looks like I just have this piece down here to finish.
So I'm just curious out there in internet land how easy it is to hear me if I'm muffled or if I sound pretty good or I need to turn it up some more. Let me know in the chat. I know we're only halfway through the show, but...
Well, now that we're halfway through the show, Mr. Crafter would like to know. All right. That's pretty cool. That's pretty cool. All right. I think I'm going to lay this one over. No, I lied to you. See, didn't mean to do that.
Thank you.
This is the one that I want to put over there. And I want to use scissors to cut this one.
Yeah, let's bring up today's message.
Oh, that's a good plan.
Those who look to him are radiant. Psalm 34, 5. Boy, as much as you look to him, you must be glowing like mad, honey.
Can't survive without him, that's for sure. All right, here we go. We are going to just slide this over, and that is now the vein of that leaf. Look at that. Voila. Voila. Yes, there's a leaf there. Really? Really? All right, I got to get these parts covered in here because, you know what? That's it, mister. You are grounded, mister. All right, I got in between these fingers needs to have something in between his little fingers.
Oh, I thought you were going to, like, draw out the outline of his fingers and then, like, so it fits.
No, it doesn't have to be that precise because we're going to go right over the top of it with the right color for the frog. So now I can move to the frog's body.
Body.
And we're just going to go ahead with this lighter green. See how that's a totally different green? And I have some brighter ones here. I think we'll use these instead for his, for this part.
On camera, this looks blue.
It's that monitor. So if that monitor was, if that image was moved over to the other monitor, it would look a little bit better. But all right, we're just going to go ahead and go with it.
What if you did, just hypothetically, not saying change what you're doing?
Oh, good, because I'm not changing what I'm doing. So I'm glad you said hypothetically. So, yes, hypothetically, what if I did what?
What if you put a big piece over what you're doing, like semi-cut out to where it fits the shape that you're doing, and then you did the smaller pieces over it?
Yeah, that's another way you can do it. There's no wrong way to do this. Like, I mean, I can put in this whole image right here, this whole piece right here, because it's, to me, that's curved very much like his mouth there. See? How convenient that there was a piece just like that. I'm going to just...
So Jewel says T hasn't handed his notice in for a while.
That's true. He hasn't.
What is that?
Well, he's used to quitting almost every week. She's used to him quitting almost every week. Yeah. It's sort of a thing.
It's a terrible joke, Dad. Don't worry.
It's sort of a thing where T-Dog quits the Kraaft It Live show almost every week, right?
Can we fire him?
No, we can't afford to fire him. Mm.
Andrew says, ouch, she amputated Froggy's finger.
Yeah, we really can't afford to fire him. We can't afford to keep him. I mean, we're kind of behind a wall there. Little bit of a jam, he says.
Stuck between a rock and a hard place.
Just strawberry.
Struck between a leaf and a piece together sky. He's starting to look like a frog, isn't he? A little bit. Actually,
yeah.
He's looking less like a frog than he was before I put anything down, just going to be honest, but that's okay. I'm hoping to be able to get to the end of this. We don't want to leave without showing folks.
We'll finish the leave.
That was terrible. Honestly, that was terrible, Greg.
Make like a tree.
No. No dad jokes today. No dad jokes.
I never get to do the dad jokes anymore.
No. The dad jokes are bad. That's why we don't allow the bad jokes. You have never been allowed to do the dad jokes. You just choose to do them without permission. That's pretty much how it's been.
Yeah, but some of them are funny.
None of them are funny. None of them. Like, that's... That's the mistake that you think.
I'm going to quit instead of T-Dog. Forget this.
All right.
Cool, can I have what? Can I have my job back then? Oh, Travie wants my job.
All right, here we go.
You can't handle
Putting the pieces in here. You guys are goofs. Putting the pieces in. Here we go. We are not sanctioned. We are not sanctioned for this to be a USC fight. No. UFC fight. There's all kinds of rules and stuff. We can't. We don't do that here anyway. Probably is. Probably YouTube would take us down. Yeah, pretty much. All right, I'm trying to figure out where this shape fits best. I think right here. Let's put that finger there. This actually looks like his elbow already. I may have just totally destroyed that piece. Yeah, I sure did. That's all right. Just, I want to be in keeping with torn bits. I like it.
Why don't you put all the jelly plate pieces through a shredder then?
That wouldn't be as fun.
Now the pieces are sticking to me.
So if they're not travelers yet, they can go onto the website and sign up for that. Or even hitchhikers.
Yeah, the hitchhikers are free. So, of course, if you're looking for a free option, just want to see what in the world it's about, I totally get that. That just puts you onto our newsletter. And I'm so slow at working at all this stuff, getting back into the groove of things, being able to get through the stuff that's going on from day to day. You guys get it. Everybody struggles.
Now we got the online group inciting riots, honey.
Uh-oh.
Suzanne, is it wrong to say I want to hear a dad joke? Is that inciting a riot?
Go ahead. Give him a dad joke. Now you can't. See, yeah. That's the way it works. If you request a joke, he can't do it. That's the way it works.
I'll think of one before the end of the show, maybe.
All right. So I've got orange fingers to put down here.
Let us know before so that we can plan our ears.
All right. A little bit more on his mouth over here.
I don't know where a lot of people are at from online, but it's finally cooling off temperatures around here, and it's feeling decent.
So nice, finally. I've had the door open almost every day this week. Well, I mean, it's only Tuesday, but I meant like the last several days. Oh, that was funny. Unintentionally.
Every day.
Hey, that's a huge deal in Arizona, to say the least. All right, I'm moving the canvas just so I can get these edges. I can actually trim those off when we're done, so there's no reason to do that, but certain things I just can't see it until it's gone, I guess. All right, what is this? Oh, this is orange. Okay, orange. Where are you, orange? My goodness, are we going to get through this whole thing, you think?
Aren't you busy?
I am very busy. Thank you for asking. Oh, brother, somebody got him started. Now we're in big trouble. Don't encourage him, audience. Don't encourage him. All right, let's see if I can get this one to work as a finger.
You really shouldn't give them the finger.
I'm giving the audience the finger, the orange finger, no less.
No.
All right. Let's see. I think this one needs to go like this. This is where I'm going to sort of take some creative license and make it a little bit different than the original, which is good, I think. Even if it's not, even if nobody agrees with me, I'm still doing it anyway. There so that go. Works.
It's just like you.
Typical.
Yep.
I don't know what you two are doing, but we are doing a live show right now. Could you not do that, please? Crazy kids.
He's taken two hands to meet me at thumb wrestling.
Oh, my goodness. They're thumb wrestling. That's We're doing bad. This live show, and you guys are thumb wrestling. Those are just some of the perks that you get to see in person when you show up at a live art concert.
She keeps us separated when we're in concerts.
Out in public, that's what you mean to say, when we're out in public. Go.
He started it.
He started it. I was waiting for that. Hold the safety rope. No one let go of the safety rope. All right, so this little frog has got some digit issues.
He's got digitalis.
He's got digitalis. I don't know what that is. Should not have said that. That is not right. I don't know what that is. I apologize if that was something wrong that we should not have said. We're going to Google that later.
Actually,
please, Andrew, don't add it.
Will.
Don't tell us what it is. Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness. Okay, I'm going to try... I'm going to try and ignore you. Yes, that is my goal right now, is to ignore you as best I can. All right, so this, let's see. I'm going to do it with this one first and see if
Jewel
I can't.
Jewel says it's a plant.
Digitalis is a plant?
Well, you're
Praise God.
The leaf.
Praise God, because that it really, you had me nervous. You really had me nervous. Yeah, now we've offended all botanists everywhere. But I do that quite regularly anyway because I'm not very good at the whole botany thing.
How do you
defend
robots?
That's not what botanist means, Travis. It's not.
It should be what it means.
It's not robots.
Can we just change the English language to be something else?
You are so strange.
I know. That's why you like me.
That's why I like you. Yeah. All right. I don't know if this is working
or not. Is that a bloodshot eye from him drinking all night?
Whoa.
Too far. Too far. You took that one way too far there. Way too far.
Whoa.
All right. So far, this is our frog. He looks exactly like the original. Look at him.
Keep that up there for another second.
Why? Why? I want to know what you're going to do with it.
I'm not going to do anything.
All right, let's see.
Cover up that entire face.
No, I'm just adding a layer to get rid of this white. And this is a very see-through layer, so.
Is it slap happy time? Is that what's going on?
Probably for you, it's slap happy time.
Oh, Andrew. Due to orders from she who must be obeyed, I'm officially mum.
Seriously, I'm afraid of the Googling because God only knows what you just said. But
digitalis is usually soreness from overuse or abrasion, according to Susan.
Okay, thank you, Susan. Really, really, I'm hoping we don't offend anyone. Can we just let it go, guys? Seriously, I'm getting afeared now.
Kathy says, I'm very impressed that you can chat and work at the same time.
Yeah, we're all impressed, Kathy. It's impressive by no means here. Okay.
She does it so much.
I talk and do things all the time at the same time, don't I? And yep. and sometimes I actually get things done. Okay, this is what we're going to stop with at this moment. Then we're going to dry it because I can't work with it at this point. So we're going to dry it, and then we are going to use our markers, and we just might finish this. We might finish this.
No,
we just, no, I'm serious.
No way.
No, I'm serious.
I don't think so.
Uh-huh. Serious. Because my thoughts are, I'm going to use my paint markers to outline them, give them a little bit of definition, not too much, and then we are going to use this really cool product. For those of you who watch The Hop already, you've already seen this in action, but this mixed media transfer foil. Okay, first of all, I have to tell you, foil has been my nemesis. Okay, so I have been wanting so badly to add foil to my artwork for such a long time, and I've spent like 20 or 30, Mr. Crafter, could you not listen for just a moment? I've spent like $20 or $30 on gold leaf, thinking that was what I needed. I mean, look at this art piece that they show as an example. That's pretty cool. So I really wanted to do something with it, that gold foil, but it's so persnickety. I mean, it's like incredibly, well, without telling you too much, I'm going to do a video on it. I'm going to show you the difference between this gold foil. It's actually gold leaf, premium gold leaf. It's very expensive compared to this too. And these transfer foil sheets, and you're going to see them in action tonight before I finish. So,
what do you mean
it's persnickety. I'll explain it later. Do you really have to ask that now?
Yes.
No. All right. So I have paint markers. I have.
Inquiring minds want to know.
Well, I don't want to tell you. Okay. So, right now, I think instead of using my paint markers, I'm going to use these big brush pens. And it is dry, so I can use these. And now because it's been coated with a whole lot of the matte medium.
From who?
Me. I just did it.
What matte medium?
This is matte medium right here.
From who?
Deco Art.
Oh, okay.
Okay. Sorry. Anyway, it's a non-porous surface, so now I can actually use these markers and spread them out. So these are permanent.
Permanent what?
Markers. I'm going to add some details. That's all right with you guys. Unless, of course, you don't want me to do it, then I won't, but thank you. It has been approved by the council, I was just told, so we may move forward, everyone. And I need a black.
You have your crafting permit.
You have been granted permission. You may move forward. Boy, you guys are in a mood tonight. Okay.
Mood of what?
Oh, goodness.
I think this is hunger.
This is what happens when you're hungry and tired. Got it. Now we know. All right, so I can sort of straighten that out a little. I like how organic the shapes are, but I still want to fill in some of them so that they're definitely the shapes I was going for.
Kathy says she loves big brush pens.
Yeah, they're the best.
And Jules says glue for fingernail foiling dries tacky, which is good for foiling. A glue called the best glue ever also dries tacky for foiling.
Awesome. Yeah, this media glue that we're going to use tonight is incredible for it. And it's not expensive, so.
What markers are those?
These are big brush pens by Faber-Castell. I just got a wet baby wipe. That's what I had to go get, was a baby wipe, so that I can smear this edge better. Put just a little bit of a shadow under his arm here and around the edge of that leaf. And we're just going to smear it around. Add a little bit of depth. What do you guys think of that? Is that cool? Isn't that neat? No, I think this is good. I think they want to see the whole thing come together this way. And then you can also go around the outside edge of the frog himself. Let's see, I got to make sure I do this right though. And then before it dries, give it a good smear with a wet finger here from the baby wipe. Isn't that cute? Look at that. Give that guy a little character just like that. That's so cute. Well, he's a frog and he's hanging out on a leaf and he's got all these people watching him. What would you think he'd be doing? Cute.
Susan asked a question, but I gotta wait a second to ask it to you.
Okay. All right, I gotta fix this, so I just wipe it with a baby wipe before it dries, and I can fix it. See? Voila! Just like that.
Susan asks, let's see here, are those pens pricey? Some Faber-Castell are.
Yeah, individually, yes, but I bought these almost 5 years ago, and they still are going strong. So to me, they're more like an investment because they are such a great pen. So it's about how much use you'll get out of them. And personally, I get quite a bit of use out of them. I like using them this way, and they last a long time. They're a permanent pen, so they won't smear after they're dried. These are all reasons for me to want them and use them. And when you use something, even if it costs, like let's just say in the US, these cost about five bucks, $3 to $5, depending on where you get them. Per, or you could get a whole set and then they're even less per, but you get the idea.
Yes, we do. Amazing how that just jumps out like that.
Now all of a sudden he has shape and he's actually a frog, not just a blob anymore, huh? That's yep. Pretty cool. I gotta concentrate while I do this part, apparently. All right, orange for this part of the hand.
For the fingers that disappeared?
For the fingers that
got
disappeared.
Amputated.
What do you think of him now?
Very cool.
I'm able to fix anything that didn't work with the paper. Just like that. Voila! Look at him, he's so cute! Alright, let's go back to this and put the pupil of the eye in. Commit to it, Heather, just commit to it.
Alice is here. She said, use coupons at Hobby Lobby. Or Ace More or Michaels usually can save at least 40%.
Yep. That's the best way to buy any kind of craft supplies is using those coupons, of course. But coupons aren't available for everyone, that's for sure. But if you can, use them. He looks a little scared now. That's cute. Isn't that cute?
Cute as a Dickens.
Okay.
Susan says, I think she's gorgeous. Alice is very cool.
You know what we need is a name for this one. Jane named, I have to tell you guys, let me fix this first and then I'll tell you. Jane named this one Fergus. This is Fergus the frog. So now we need a name for this one. Anybody watching can go ahead and give it a name if you're watching live or in the recording. And I'll let you know next week what the name ended up being.
Enclave says Larry.
Larry. I like Larry. We'll see. Tune in next week to find out what the name actually is.
And there's T-Dog in the camera.
Nice. Look at you trying to hide from the camera now. How cute.
I don't know if you can see that picture behind Heather there.
This one?
Yeah, that's your 31-day Dealey Bob.
Yeah. I doubt they can see that very well. It's small and dark. Just giving a little bit of shadow so that our little froggy here will pop out a little bit more. That's good. Hard to see that where you guys are sitting, but there you go. All right, final bits are here. Might need to do a little bit more of that leaf work there, but just going to blur that edge. Turn it so we can get a better. You do have a little bit of playtime with this, especially if you're using a wet baby wipe. It's quite nice. That's cool. Isn't that cool?
Pull it down. Yep. Kathy said awesome. Danny says very cute. Jewel says he popped. Alice says very cool. Alice says Frank Frog. Susan says looks like Barbara to me.
Barbara. I love that. All right, one more little bit here underneath this. I just really like to put some shadows underneath those fingers. So it really does look like it's there. Find a new spot on the baby wipe here.
So what do you say? If they like it, give it a thumbs up. Is that what?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we really like thumbs ups on it. Yeah, then
tell us later.
Yeah, if you don't like it, keep it to yourself. We don't want to hear about that junk. No, I'm just kidding. All right, what do you think?
Very cool. All
right, so the last thing that I want to do, I have to fix this. This is bugging me.
She's never done, just so you know.
That's not true. I can be done. I can.
But does she want to be?
It's a little bit of shadow there. Oh, look at him. He's so cute. Okay, the last thing that I want to do is make sure this is dry. And then I'm going to get myself a paintbrush, a nice paintbrush here. Oh, I like him. He's got so much texture. I don't know if you guys can see that, if it comes out on camera or not, but there's like shiny bits and there's all this wrinkly texture bits and book papers and all kinds of stuff.
Did the scissors disappear?
No, they're right there. They're actually in a couple of spots. You probably got to see it in person, though, to really see all that's there. All right. I think that's dry.
I think that can be said about all of your art.
Yeah, you have to see it in person. You really do. All right. Here we go. This is the magic, y'all. We are going to take this Rebecca Meyer Designs Mixed Media Medium from Thermal Web. Now, I will tell you, Thermal Web did send me these products for our blog hop, so I'm not being paid to love their products. It just turns out that way. Like, seriously, this, I'm going to be honest, when I got the box, I was like, I don't need this stuff, first of all. Secondly, is it really going to be any good? I mean, I am like such not a fan of the foil. I mean, I was not even kidding you guys when I said the foil is my nemesis. And if Sylvia was here, she would say she and I have struggled with the foil. Now, she'll say that I've struggled less than she did, but she always does that, so you don't have to listen to her. And she's not here to defend herself, so I can say whatever I want. But the truth is, we continually battle with the foil, and we've tried so many types. I mean, so many different glues, so many different things. We've tried. And I'm just going to put just a little bit there, maybe a little bit on this finger and this finger here.
What is she doing?
All right. So I just painted some of this media gel on here. Hey, T-Dog, can I get you to rinse this brush before it gets stuck this way? This would be a good time for me to take a drink. Everybody just hold on. All right, we're going to give this a little bit of a dry. What was really cool was when I did the video for the pairs, the blog hop video or video hop, whatever, I tested everything for the very first time right there live on camera. So I had never used any of the products until I was doing that live there on camera. And you got to see it. If you watch that video, you got to see exactly what I experienced. So, all right, hopefully you can see the sticky. See that sticky stuff there?
No, it's shiny.
Yeah. So now we're going to take out antique pearl foil. This is the worst part, is getting it out of a sticky package. And I figured out how to do it. You fold this part back so the sticky is facing up and away from the foil. Now you can take that out nice and easy. And then I got my paintbrush back, which is cool, because now I can use the paintbrush, the back side of the paintbrush, or I could use my finger. Don't need to use a tool. But my fingers are sticky from from gluing down all that paper. So I'm just going to, you guys see that? The transfer foil is so cool. All right. And I think, if I remember correctly, we put some down here. We put some here. Are they seeing that on camera yet?
Yeah, it's there.
Oh my gosh, he's so cute. Look at that.
Yeah.
Isn't that fun?
That's awesome.
Isn't that fun? I mean, that was so simple. Like, where have you been all my life? This foil. It doesn't matter. Probably somewhere in someone's mind. All right, the only thing left that I would like to do maybe would be to trim these edges off. But if you can just imagine that they're trimmed, so I don't have to do it right now, that'd be great. Just pretend that's been trimmed.
Told you, she's never done.
But just, I mean, I'm serious. That's, come just on, imagine. Right? What do you guys think of that? Why don't we have applause? We should have applause. We need a laugh track and applause track. And it needs to not be pitiful. That's pitiful. All right. That's it for me, you guys. Here's Fergus from last week. Here's yet to be named from this week. The exact same image, just done two different ways. And next week, we're going to be doing something totally different, but we'll be using the jelly plate. So you definitely want to show up for that, because that's going to be a lot of fun. And I think it's going to look even different than this, the end result. So join us next week, and we will see you then, you guys. Is that it? Did I miss anything?
No, I don't think so.
Okay. Have a crafty day, everybody. Have a great week. Bye.
Jewel says, foil the edges, Heather.